Good morning, and everybody, welcome to OAG. We're happy to have you here today. If you would, go ahead and stand. One of the great things that I love about Father's Day here in churches is we get to celebrate our Father. As a father, having the greatest father, man, it is an example that we unfortunately sometimes fall short of. As a father, you know what I'm talking about. So what I would ask for you today is I ask everyone to go ahead and close your eyes. Let's lift up our voices to God. Let's get right before our Father, and then let's go into worship and praise Him. Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you for being the good Father. Thank you for being the one that we can rest on. Lord, thank you for being our strength in the midst of the storm. Lord, thank you for being that shelter. As a good Father, you have wrapped your arms of love around us. And Lord, oh, it's so good to have you over us. Lord, as for myself and for the many fathers in this room, thank you for being that example for us. Lord, though we may fall short, you never fall short. Lord, though we may not be faithful, you are always faithful. Lord, I thank you that we can come to you. Lord, I pray right now, Lord, as we get ready to lift up our praise, lift up our worship to you. Lord, I pray right now, Lord, that you will hear it, Lord, and that it will bring you joy today. Lord, I thank you for being my Father. Lord, I thank you for pouring yourself out on a cross for us. And Lord, hear our praise, hear our worship as we exalt you above everything else, as we exalt you above our problems that we walked in here today with. Lord, above all of the situations that we find ourselves in, Lord, you are greater, you are stronger than any battle, any fight, any struggle that we are finding ourselves in. Heavenly Father, Lord, I pray that you will just be with us today. Reveal yourself to us today. Lord, we thank you. And it's in Jesus' name that I pray. Amen.
Remember those walls that we called sin and shame. Thank you. Praise the Lord. Thank you, worship team. That's amazing, amazing praise and worship. Happy Father's Day to all of you fathers out there. But I also would like a shout out to those who fill the role of father as well. Amen. They deserve a little love as well on this day. We're at a time in our service we're going to offer up a few prayers. I pray that you join me together, unity, one heart, one prayer for a few needs in our church. Bow your heads, please. Father God, we lift up our brother Kevin Powers, Lord, who is in the hospital here locally, developed a blister or blisters. Father, the blood work indicated there's a possibility of some infection, but Lord, we know that you have got it. We know, Lord, there'll be no infection. We know our brother will be healed quickly and be back here home with Karen and here with us on Wednesday night, Father. Be with him where he is now, Lord. Lay your hand of protection upon him. Let everything that the doctors have planned be your plan. Father, we lift up our kids, Lord, who head out to kids camp this week, Lord. We just pray for safe travel. We pray for new friends. We pray for them to draw closer and closer to you, Father. For our dear brother, Jeff Musselman, who's here with us today. Lord, I pray for complete healing from his stroke, Lord. It's so good to have him here in the house with us, a testimony to your great love, your answers to prayer, Father. And as he heads into rehabilitation, Father God, go before him. Make whatever the doctors have planned for him to work perfectly, Father God. For our dear sister, Pat Madeline, Lord, who today is serving in nursery, Lord, we pray for continued healing and strength in her as she deals with these difficult pains in her back, Father. We pray your loving hand upon her. We pray the blood of Jesus over her for complete healing. For our brother Chris Vitello, who's lost his grandfather. Lord, losing a loved one is never easy, Lord, but we need to draw on the love, the wonderful memories we have with them, Lord, to sustain us until we're reunited there in heaven with them. For Praise Assembly of God in Charleston, Illinois, Pastor Ryan Mulvaney, Lord, we just pray your Holy Spirit over that service today, Lord. And for Jason Harsbarger in Chi Alpha, Illinois State University, Father, we know you're doing great things in that brother's life and all the work that he is doing for you there. We pray for continued blessings over him and open doors and resources, Father God, and many lives, many of those college students, Lord, would just come to know you as their Lord and Savior. We pray all this in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
And everybody said, God bless you. You may be seated. Good to see each of you. It's good to see families together, bringing honor, bringing love, and bringing respect to Dad and to Father. So we do recognize all of the dads today. I would like all of you to stand. I would like every father to stand right now. And could we just give a little bit of Father's Day love to each of these men? Happy Father's Day. Happy Father's Day to each and to every one of you. God bless you. You may be seated. Dads, at the end of the service, I want to call you just to join up with me around the front, and we're going to have a special prayer that the Lord will place over our lives and the role and the ministry that he has given to us. It's an opportunity for us to worship the Lord with our giving. And this verse, it's a Father's Day verse, but there's a couple of words I want to focus on. Psalms 103:13. As a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. He has compassion on those who fear him. Do you fear the Lord? Do you fear his word? Do you honor his word? Dads, since it is Father's Day, may we take the lead in our giving, bringing the tithe and the offering into the house of the Lord. Let's do it through an action that our kids, they're going to be leaving in just a moment, let them see us in our worship, bringing our gift before the Heavenly Father. Let's bow our heads. Father, we love you today. We just thank you for this day to honor you and to love you. And then, Lord, to just love on and to bring honor to all of the dads here today, Lord. that are in service. And so in this next step of worship, Lord, it's very individual, it's very personal, but Father, it is biblical and it is scriptural, and I thank you for giving us direction regarding the tithe and the offerings. Dads take the lead, moms and all the others, Lord, will then follow. But I pray that you bless this time of worship as, Lord, we honor you and we reverence you. And, Lord, we just let the word of God go forth. So bless right now in Jesus' name this action. And everyone said, God bless you as you give.
That was beautiful. Thank you so much, Miss Dana, for that just incredible arrangement of how deep the Father's love for us. And if you don't know that song, I encourage you to go look up the word sometime today and let that just wash over you today on Father's Day, that the Father's love for us is so much more than we could ever imagine. So at this time, I want to encourage you to greet those around you. And if you are new, I want to encourage you to fill out a Connect card. We have an online version that you can get to by scanning this QR code in your camera app, or you can fill out the form that's on the card in front of you, in the seat back in front of you. So go ahead and stand up to your feet, and when you see a video playing, that is your cue to find your seat and get back so we can continue on. And this is the time to dismiss the boys and girls back to Kids Church.
Don't forget to carry the one.
Okay. That was delicious. Thank you. Right, hold on there, kiddo.
Dad.
Say cheese.
Cheese.
There you go. Okay, just one more. Hold your trophy up a little bit higher.
Dad.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. It's time to rise and shine.
Dad.
Love it.
No.
Dad. Dad.
And they were here first.
So Dad.
So you want to go catch a movie at like 7:30 or something?
Dad.
And one more. Okay, one more.
Okay, let's go.
Wait. Come on. Just one more. One more.
Dad.
I'm so proud of you. Now you just gotta get a job.
Dad!
You look beautiful.
Oh, Dad.
And stand just a little closer together and move just a little bit to the left. My left. A little more.
Dad!
We love that little video. The staff picked it out just for all of our fathers. And we all can remember all of those different moments and times in our kids' lives. Dads, once you're a dad, you're always a dad. Always a dad, carrying it all the way through past the kids that are in the home, though they might have left and gone on. You know what? You've got grandkids that have come, or great-grandkids, or even great-great or great-great-grandkids. It's beautiful to talk about and to share the role that all of our dads have. So, fathers, once again, happy Father's Day to you. In the service today, we can see one another. Everybody just kind of look around and just see three or four people. Look them in the eye and just give them a big smile. All right, do that. Look them in the aisle. Some of you forgot who's around you, but I just want you to take note. And at the same time, we are missing some folks that are not able to be here today. And so whether they're in the hospital, like Kevin Powers, Kevin, it's good to see you because I know you're watching. Or Effie Wiley. I check on Effie and say, Effie, did you watch the service? Yes. And so, Effie, we just recognize you. And also today hang on a second, it's coming to me. Linda Janicek. There you go. Linda Janicek is at home and awaiting surgery and in such pain that she's not able to literally just sit in a seat. Probably Cameron might be watching. So for all of those that are watching at home, could we just give them, hey, we know that you're with us in service today. Give them a big old hand clap of praise. I just want to recognize all of you. And as Les mentioned in the prayer time, it's good to have Jeff Musselman in service. I'd rather have you in service than have to visit you in the hospital. Man, he fills a hospital bed. I'm telling you what, as I went to see him, he just was filling that bed. And man, I tell you what, he's a big guy. And I'm just grateful that the Lord is bringing his healing touch and his mercy in your life. We're continuing to pray for you. Well, a couple things. Remember, all of our kiddos that are going up to kids camp this week, remember them in prayer for God to just give them an encounter, a tremendous time of just meeting with the Lord. And then we do want to talk about Vacation Bible School, though it might be maybe 5 weeks away or so. Registration has started. We've already been having moms and dads register their kids. And so that will be happening all the way up until the 22nd. But here's where we need your help. And so right now, all of the sets and the backdrops are being painted. And so we need painters. If you'd like to help in that area, see my wife Tammy. Or well, Pastor Ashton will be gone this week, so you need to see Tammy if you'd like to get involved in that. And then also the rest of you, last year we had an average of 80 that served. From young to old, we have about 80 workers and volunteers. We're probably going to have to step that up a little bit because we're believing for more. Everybody say more. More in 24. So we had an incredible year last year. But in order for us to make preparations, I'd like for us to see between 90 and 100 that we have of workers. So there is a sign-up sheet at the Welcome Center on your way out. Just go ahead and put your name down. Let us know that you are ready to go and ready to serve. All right, well, take your Bibles and let's go to Genesis chapter 18, verse number 19. It's just one verse of Scripture that we want to look at today. And we'll read it in just a moment, but I want it to be right in front of you, Genesis 18, 19. Let me tell you just a little story first. This Father's Day story. A man and a wife had a disagreement. Yep. It was over the purchase of a car. What did he want? A fancy sports car. She wanted a hybrid, economical, small car. They couldn't agree. Back and forth they went, back and forth they went. He said he wanted something that would go from zero to 200 in seconds. She didn't care how fast the car went, as long as it got from A to B and got the best gas mileage. Well, they couldn't agree on which car, so you know what? They didn't talk about it for a week, but Father's Day was coming. And Dad, he was anticipating something very special that year. His wife got him a package. It was a nice square package, kind of thin. He was wondering, oh, is this the car manual? Or could it be she put the car keys in it? I just know it's got to be my sports car. I know my wife is going to go ahead and bless me with that. And so he shook it. He didn't hear any rattling of the keys. He didn't know. Maybe it was a big, heavy, thick manual. So he rips into his Father's Day square package. And he was thrilled but stunned to find his very own personal, individual, stylish, black and silver 2024 model bathroom scales. She wrote in his Father's Day card, "You said you wanted to go fast and something that goes from 0 to 200 in a matter of seconds. Voila! Happy Father's Day." I don't think there's any wives out there going to do something like that today. I hope I didn't give that sort of an idea. But I tell you what, dads, you're going to have a special afternoon with your families, and who knows what sort of gifts the kids might bring or the wife might bring or the meal. Here's some of these words as we think about the world according to, everybody say it, Dad, as we saw in the video. Some of the words that are very, very familiar, very special, even special and memorable. And maybe you might be able to kind of finish some of these statements. They're so well known. Dads would say something like this: "This is going to hurt me more than it hurts you." "Quiet, please. I'm watching the game. Here's $10. Bring me back all of the change. Hey, kids, money doesn't grow on." "How should I know? Go ask your mother. "When I was your age, I walked 5 miles to and from school each and every day, both uphill and down. Plus, it was also in the snow and rain." "Just wait until you have kids of your own." "And I was not asleep. I was only resting my eyes." Well, some of those familiar dad statements, I remember a few of them, heard a few of them as well. But fathering is a privilege. Being a dad is an honor. Sometimes being a dad is like holding unformed jello in your hands. It's a little difficult as you're trying to kind of balance it and juggle it. I don't believe there's any perfect dad. How many would agree? There's no perfect dads, but I believe what we need to really emphasize is we need to have present dads. Dads that are present, dads that are near, dads that are close. Fathers, yes, there's every stage of our lives, new fathers. My son is a new father. He's probably three and a half months old. As a dad, watching him care for his little daughter is pretty special. Others, first, second, and third time that maybe for your Father's Day. And others of you, how many have got 40-plus years being a father? Go ahead and lift your hands up. We've got some veterans in the house leading and caring and loving on children. But there's also stepfathers. There's adoptive fathers. There's single fathers. Yep, there are probably some workaholic fathers, maybe even an absentee father, and hopefully no deadbeat fathers in the house today. The late Billy Graham said this, and if we can post that, let's all look at it together. "A good father is one of the most unsung, unpraised, unnoticed, and yet one of the most valuable assets in our society." Dads, you are needed in the home. You're not only needed in the home, you're needed in God's house. As all of us serve to lead, all of us serve to encourage and to build the next generation. As we look at Genesis chapter 18, verse 19, focusing on just that one verse, understand kind of where we're looking at as we just have come through the 17th chapter. If you look back and understand that Abraham is going to have a son at 99 years of age, he's receiving this. If you look at verse 17 of the 17th chapter, he couldn't contain himself and he laughed. He just had to let it out. You're going to talk about me at 100? You said next year I'm going to be a dad? Well, then we find even Sarah, she, in the same token, chapter 18, she would laugh as well at the thought. And so we kind of come through all of that, and we understand that Abraham is going to be the father of many nations. I mean, just think of generations that will come from him. And there's a word that is spoken in this 19th verse. If we could, let's all look at it together. Let's read it. Then we're going to stop and ask God to just let his word be a blessing to especially our fathers today. Verse 19, "For I have chosen him so that he will direct his children and his household after him to keep the way of the Lord by doing what is right and just, so that the Lord will bring about for Abraham what he has promised him." Let's bow our hearts, bow our heads. Father, we thank you for this day, this service, Lord, to bring honor and love and respect, Lord, to all of the dads. And as you spoke to Abraham, as you charged and challenged him, Lord, would you speak to every father today? Would you encourage every father today, Lord, to be that godly father, to be that loving father, to be that strong father in the home, leading after God's own heart. And so, God, I pray that you would just encourage. I pray that you would, Lord, bless. And I pray that you would prepare the table as we come to it today. We ask all of these things in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. All right, let's look at some of the things that's wrapped up in this verse today. Dads, you are chosen by God. When you look at that word and understand, there is no just accident here. You have been selected. You have been handpicked. You have been chosen to go ahead and serve as the father of your kids, to minister to each and every one of them. Every one of them is different. Every one of them is not just cookie cutter. You've got some high achievers, and you've got others that are a little bit on the other, just a little bit slower on their ideals and maybe focuses. But the word chosen, think about this, is the Hebrew word yada. And it simply means this, that he has chosen you, and he has knowledge of you. He has understanding of your role. He has picked you. He knows that with all of our flaws, sometimes even our fears, first-time dads, wow, what do we do? How do we lead? How do we care for our kids? He's chosen us. He's selected us to be the man in charge within the home. So God knew Abraham. God knew his heart. God knew his character. God knew what he was like, and he chose him to be the father of many nations. Think about that. All of those that would come from him, those that would follow the example. And dads, we have the role. We have the opportunity to fashion, to mold, to shape. And we got little eyes that are watching us. Sometimes when we don't think they're watching, they're watching. They're looking. They're inspecting how we do what we do. God's man, Abraham, wanted to go ahead and lead his children. He wanted to set the stage, if you will. But just being known that you are chosen, I think this is the most important thing. God has picked us. You weren't chosen because of your position or of your schooling. You weren't chosen by your bank account. You weren't chosen by how much you can lift over your head or how much you can't lift over your head. You were chosen to influence that little child, for that little one to be everything that God has created them to be. Dads, your children need what you have to give them. Words of affirmation, words of love, words of encouragement, words of identity and value. God wants to use your hugs. He wants to use your kisses. He wants to use your discipline. He wants to use your one-on-one moments with your children to stamp His eternal identity on the hearts of the children. God said to Abraham, I've chosen you because I know you. Dads, God has chosen you and He knows what you have to offer and how that you're vital in the home. We know that there are a lot of homes without fathers today. Sometimes the single mom picks up the responsibility and is trying to handle both roles to be a leader. But dads, go ahead and lead and show your kids God's love and God's grace. It's a responsibility that we've been charged with, and we've got to take it very seriously. Number two, look at this. You will direct your children and your household. I've chosen him so that he will direct. You're the leader. You're the one that has to speak the truth. You're the one that has to say no. Yes, you can say yes, but at times you've got to say no. Or how about we talk about it later? You're the one to direct in your house. God has empowered you. God has equipped you. God has sustained you to be the leader that you are. You're to direct your kids. You're the dad, not the kids being the one in charge and telling dad what to do. Sometimes we see the reversal. We see that sometimes out in public, that the kids are just really leading everything that mom or dad is doing. No, dad, you're the leader. Don't abdicate and don't abandon your role. Go ahead and serve as directing your children in the way that they should go. Everybody say, should go. So when they're older, they'll not depart from that path. Oh, if they do depart, let's pray God that they'll come right back because of the encouragement and the leadership that our dads have. A real father invests time in directing his children through teaching and disciplining, mentoring, modeling, guiding, leading, showing the way. As I said earlier, there's no perfect dad, but dads that are present is pretty powerful to be present in your child's life. There's a story about a little girl who loved art. She loved to draw pictures, and so she was working on this picture, and she got it all finished, and she came to Dad and said, Dad, I want you to see my picture. Would you come to my room? She was so overjoyed about it, but Dad wasn't as thrilled. He's not now, honey. Dad's busy. Well, 10 minutes later, you know what she's going to do. She's going to come back, get into her father's lap, try to get his face to look at him and say, honey, daddy, I've got something you've got to see. I have got a beautiful picture I've been working on, and I want you to come to my room and see it. Just getting a little frustrated. Can't you see I'm busy, honey? Don't bother me right now. I'll come and look at your picture later. Remember those words, later, but I'm not ready right now. 5 hours later, he came finally out of his office, remembered that his daughter hadn't been there in the last 5 hours, and he came. Honey, can I see the picture now? The girl said, sure, Daddy. She showed the picture of her, her brother, her mom standing in the front of their beautiful house with the family dog. Everybody, big smiles on a sunny day, the sun over in the corner. The dad noticed as he looked at the picture, he kind of studied it and said, honey, that's a beautiful picture, sweetheart, but where am I? The girl said, well, Daddy, you're always working. You're always in your office. You're never around. That's why. Kind of put a sharp sword into his heart. As he heard, as he saw the absence even in his own daughter's life. Fathers, there's no remote control dads. It just doesn't work to be present, to be leading. not just to be texting from afar, but to speak right there in front of them. Time is a gift that you give your children that you can never get back. Dads, how many will agree with that? We understand the value of our time, the value of our presence. As we look at a scripture, I want you to turn, everybody to turn in Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 6 to 9. Here is some instruction, dads, I want you to take the lead in, and I want you to see the importance of teaching and how this teaching should go about. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verses 6 to 9. If you would, share it with somebody next to you. Dads, go ahead and just lead the way. But listen to what it says. I'm going to read it out of the Living Bible. It says, and you must, and Dad, I'm just going to put you there. Dads, you must think constantly about these commandments that I'm giving you today. Dads, you must teach them to your children. Dads, you must talk about them when you're at home or out for a walk. Dads, at bedtime and the first thing in the morning. Dads, tie them on your finger, wear them on your forehead, and write them on the doorposts of your house. These truths, these eternal truths, is to be lived out, is to be spoken, is to be shared at all times. When we take them to school, some of my precious moments as a dad was taking my kids to school, and I remember dropping off the first one, dropping off the second one, and the third one, of course, was waiting along. We would go over scripture memory verses. It was something that I just loved to do as we went over and over scripture verses, and we just shared that together. Then we would pray. I would say, I love you, and just drop them off at their particular school. Moments that are moments to be treasured and moments that we must continue to live out. You get the grandkids over, you know what? I don't have as much opportunity to see Caden as I want to, or to see Ellie, though I did hear that Ellie's coming pretty soon, and I'm looking forward to that visit, the opportunity to spend moments. But every chance we get is a chance to lead with the love of God and the truth of His Word, letting it be lived out in your life. Dads, take the initiative to direct the steps that you want your kids to take. Make sure that they're spiritually fit and nourished. You're in control of their spiritual well-being. Don't leave that. Don't abdicate that. Don't share that with somebody else. You have the flashlight. Illuminate the Word of God to their path and to their way. Make sure that they understand what God says to them and wants them to know. Number three is this: fathers, you must keep the way of the Lord. This is another powerful truth. As we find two words in that text, if you look at that 19th verse again, for I have chosen him so that he will direct his children and his household. What's the next two words? After him. To keep the way of the Lord. It's we must lead the way. We can't expect others to do that. We can't expect others in our home. But first, let's go ahead and follow the path ourselves. Let's hear. Let's listen. And then let's lead ourselves so that they after us will follow our witness, our example, follow our model and how that we're going after the Lord. Are we setting the proper spiritual place in our home? Dads, where our family can see, hear, and know, and then take suit to come after us. Let's keep the way of the Lord. The word keep, I want you to write some of these other words down. Dads, write this down. The Hebrew word for keep is then mentioned in these words: to watch, to guard, to observe, to heed, and to cling to. As we keep the way of the Lord, we're going to watch, we're going to guard, we're going to observe, heed, and cling to God's way. in God's plan. Psalms 128 has four verses that shares some beautiful truth. So dads, let me read that. Psalms 128, 1 through 4. And listen to what it says. Blessed are all who fear the Lord, who walk in His ways. Blessed are those who walk in His ways. Because if you're walking in the way of the Lord, no doubt others are going to follow after your example and have the same passion and heart that you have because you've demonstrated it. You want to have some blessing? Listen to this. You will eat the fruit of your labor. Blessings and prosperity will be yours, Dad. Your wife will be like a fruitful vine within your house. Your sons will be like olive shoots around your table, filled with life, is what it's saying. And thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. One who honors God, honors His word, lives His word out, is going to be able to experience these blessings that God wants to shower down upon us. And so if we want our kids to be knowledgeable in the word, dads, what do we have to do? We've got to be in the word, and we've got to be studying it ourselves. If we want our kids to worship God, don't just drop them off on Wednesday or Sunday, but come in and lead the way with how we worship the Lord, bringing them into the house of God. If you want your kids to be good stewards of money, then that means you, I. We need to be good stewards, responsible in our care of the finances that God has blessed us with. If you want your kids to tithe, dads, what do you need to do? We need to tithe and set the stage. Even talk to them about it. Share with them what a tithe is. I love to see some of the kids that are coming up. You know what? They come up, and no doubt mom and dad's talking to them about it. Now, this is your part, and this is something that I want you to know what it is. And it's laying it out before them. Learning about giving and stewardship and the tithe when I was a child. Man, it was profound. It was important for me to practice it. And I remember putting aside my tithe, nickels, dimes, quarters, even some dollars as a kid, and putting it aside and then bringing it to the house of the Lord. And then watching God continue to bless year after year after year. And then sharing the truth with my kids. Seeing them be able to put that into practice. And now for them to experience God's blessings. Tammy and I consider it a joy and an honor to be able to lead that. And then lastly, dads, listen to this. You must do what is right. We must do what is just. For I have chosen him so that he will direct his children and his household after him to keep the way of the Lord by doing what is right, doing what is just. And if we do those things, so that the Lord will bring about for Abraham what he has promised him. How many wants to have what God promises you? Let me hear an amen. We want to do the things that are just and right. We're charged to do the things that are right. Maybe everybody else might not think it's right. They might not even follow the example. But dads, stand out. Step up. Take a role of spiritual authority, priesthood within your home. Micah chapter 6, verse 8 says this. And let me include it. Dads, to you. He has showed you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? To act justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God. Set the stage. Emulate before your family a man who loves God, who loves their mother, who works hard, cares for people, serves in ministry, involved, faithful, consistent. Here's a little list that I found of 10 ways to be an all-pro dad. It was from All Pro Dad. www.allpro.com. So dads, listen to this. You want to be an all-pro dad? 10 things that I think would be encouragement for us to follow. Number one, love your wife. Number two, spend time with your kids. That ministry of presence. Three, be a role model. Four, understand your children, each and every one, and how they're different. Five, show affection. Boy, that is so desperately needed, to show affection to not only mom, the wife, but to the kids. Six, enjoy your children. Enjoy times with your kids. Seven, eat together as a family. Something so valuable that I remember treasuring growing up, just having the entire family, all six of us around, well, seven. Mark, as he came along 13 years later, all of us around the home. Number eight, discipline with a gentle spirit. Nine, pray and worship together. And 10, realize that you're a father forever. It's an ongoing role. It's an ongoing ministry. Yeah, it might be demanding. It might be a responsibility that at times is difficult. But God wants us to lead. He wants us to shine. He wants us to hold the rope. He wants us to direct. He wants us to discipline. He wants us to encourage. He wants us to love. He wants us to give a whole lot of hugs. And He wants us to release when the time of release is needed and to let go. Fathers, the church doesn't need an increase in perfect fathers. It needs an increase in present fathers. I'd like all the dads, as I said, I want to encourage you to come and join us here at the front, because I want the rest of our families to pray over you and to surround you. So all the dads, could I have you to come and just stand along the front and then just face the congregation, just face your family. Would you come, all the dads, new dads, man, dads that have 20 years experience, dads with 40 years experience. Just fill the front. Would you do that from left to right? Kind of squeeze in, dads. Make sure that we can get all the dads in here. Isn't this a good group of godly dads? Come on, give them a big hand. Amen. Dale, if you could take a picture. Put your hand on the guy next to you. Would you do that? Hey, brotherhood. This is a brotherhood of dads, a brotherhood of men, a brotherhood of people who care about the next generation. And whether you're a new dad, a newbie, or whether you one with just a lot of experience, you know what? We need each other. And your families need you. Not to be their buddy, not to be just a fun guy with no seriousness. Whenever the house of the Lord and services come around Sunday and Wednesday, dads, take the lead, take the role. Please don't drop them off and say, hey, I'll see you at 8:30. Say, hey, I'll be over in the sanctuary. I'll come back and get you when service is over. Be present. Be near. Dads, just pray for the one on your left and right. And then moms and kids, would you stretch out your hand, and could we just spend this next few moments in prayer? Father, we offer ourselves as, Lord, a living witness in our home. God, we want to be flashlights that have alive batteries. Lord, we're shining the truth. We're making the truth known through our own family devotions, through our own experiences, through times of saying, no, honey, I can't let you go. I can't let you do that. Maybe you won't understand, but this is best for you. And then saying yes when that moment is right. You've earned that responsibility of purchasing your own car, and here's the keys, and yes, you can go. Lord, I just ask that you would help us to be godly dads. Help us to be like Abraham with the charge that was given to him in that 19th verse of Genesis 18. Lord, help them to walk to the Lord because they're walking after us. We're setting the pace. We're not abdicating our responsibility. We're not passing it off to our wife or to a good friend. It's our role. And once a dad, we're always a dad. Even if there's no kids in the home, we're still going to have grandkids. We're still going to have kids at church that need a godly figure. There's even some single parents, moms, that need godly dads to pick up that kind of adoptive role and just love on kids and let them know the picture of the heart of God. So, Father, I thank you for these men. I thank you for these dads. I thank you for choosing them for such a time as this. And I pray that, Lord, they would shine even brighter as the moments go on, Lord. It's going to shine even brighter as they are faithful to you, faithful to your word. Bless their marriage, bless their home, bless their work, bless everything about them. As you said in Psalms, if we fear you and honor you, Lord, then the blessing just trickles down. So let that blessing, Lord, just rain down to every area, to every part of the home. And as a result, may our church be blessed because of these men that find places to serve. Not watching others serve, but they're saying, hey, I want to serve. I want to do something. I want to follow the Lord and have my kids follow after me. So, Lord, we just commit to you, Lord, to doing better at our role. And, Father, just allowing the Holy Spirit to encourage us and to empower us and to equip us. Thank you for this title that we hold as dads. Lord, we cherish it. Father, we're going to live this out with your help. So bless our day. Bless our time together with our family. Lord, minister to those that are without fathers today. Maybe those that have already gone on to their eternal reward. As my father went on to his over 23 years ago. So Lord, bless us. Hold us and encourage us to be the man you want us to be in the home. We pray these things in Jesus' name. And everyone said, could we all stand up? Men, don't go anywhere. Just stay where you are. And I want to hear you like a chorus of men singing like you've never sung before. Everybody's going to be amazed at the voice that comes out. Here we go. Pastor Lexi, lead the way. I want to hear it. Here we go.
Oh,
Father, here we are, running to you, looking to you, so hungry and desirous for you to flood and fill our life and our way. So, Lord, I thank you for these fathers that join at the front. Lord, they understand their commitment, their role, their responsibility. And God, I just pray a double portion of blessing upon the mantle of leadership that, Lord, you've given to them, placed upon them. Help them to run to you, and may their children follow after them with the same heart, with the same desire, with the same commitment. Lord, just give them a wonderful and blessed day. And Lord, just allow them to enjoy their families. Lord, we commit ourselves to you in Jesus' name. Amen. One more time, give dads a big hand. Dads, God bless you. You can be seated and have a wonderful and awesome Father's Day. All of us at O'Fallon Assembly love you and recognize you. God bless you.